Members of the Pan-African Parliament sitting here in Johannesburg, South Africa, debated a report from the Committee of Agriculture, Environment and Natural Resources. Earlier, while presenting the committee report, the chairperson Jacqueline Amongin from Uganda urged members to adopt the proposals on achieving the Global Sustainable Development Goals in Africa.
In this regard, the PAP through its relevant committee is seeking to play a more active role in the achievement of their SDGs and monetary obligations implementation at the member state level.
Amongin asked members of the Continental Parliament, who are also MPs back home, to play a leadership role in ensuring that the SDGs are met by the UN set deadline of 2030 by adopting the appropriation and the oversight role as MPs, as well as creating awareness in their constituencies.
The oversight role of Parliament would significantly contribute to addressing many related problems and challenges that face the implementation process of various projects and programs.
But some members did not take kindly to the report. They rubbished the whole concept of sustainable development goals, arguing that they were a Western construct far removed from the African reality.
Who are exploiting our resources? The very people who set the goal. Who are destroying our environment? The very people who set the goal. Who are arming the rebels and resistance movement in Africa? The same people who set the goal. And you think you'll be able to achieve it?
I think aim at many things which we cannot attain. I think that to combat the struggle should be to attain the basic, the fundamentals.
They instead urged the Pan-African Parliament, an organ of the African Union, to focus on issues that concern Africa, and urged the leaders in the African Union Heads of State Summit to focus on Africa's solutions to Africa's challenges.
These countries have been able to set an agenda for us on all the issues. And I think as long as our countries economically depend on the West, in the West, then the agenda for this one to continue to be set.
On the other hand, a number of legislators called for the adoption of the report with its recommendations. They argued that Africans should not blame others but themselves for the underdevelopment in many parts of the continent.
Relegate our poverty, our situation, to externalities. Let us try to compartmentalize those factors that Africa themselves are responsible for and how we can address them. Let us also delineate those factors responsible for our poverty that are external to our other partners.
We should pick out the SDGs, which are very important, the one of health, the one of maternal health.
The president is not convinced that women are key drivers in the realization of sustainable development, and it's therefore prudent that Parliament can play a very, very big role to harness the empowerment of women, and more so to harness and accelerate the gender and equity in line with goal 5.
But we cannot continue every day to blame up external. For example, let's say the issue of gender. It is not our external people that are saying that we cannot agree on gender equality. We should not be taking our down from school. It is not the external people. SGN is not the external people.
I want to say the motion which has been put for the creation of another committee.
The mover of the motion, Jacqueline Amongin, insisted that the SDGs were an important blueprint for socio-economic development and that some African countries were already on course to achieve the goals.
Step 8 has ratified, and I want to explore you to read further and understand the stages where now your member state has reached in terms of, by the time you sign, you should be committed. You know that we have been fighting hard because our heads of state signed.
She also argued that most of these global goals relate to health, and that since the health situation in many parts of African countries were wanting, it was important to work to reverse the situation for the good of the people.
Away from what we are mandated to do as legislators of the continent in terms because we have a plethora as members of parliament. Two.
Some MPs at the Pan-African Parliament think that it's high time they start coming up with policies that tackle issues that affect the African people, rather than relying on strategies that are brought by the Western world. Now, in today's deliberation, the SDGs took the main center, as many of them argued that the SDGs could be a good method of trying to help Africa, but it's more of a Western policy. Maurice Ochol, NTV, at the Pan-African Parliament here in Johannesburg, South Africa.